Subscribe to Drama YT and press the bell icon to get the latest videos first of the all. Hey guys, how are you? It's K2 and welcome back to Drama YT. In this video, I will be counting down my top 10 Chinese dramas where the male lead comes to take revenge but instead falls for the girl. Revenge can be theme in a drama, but it would be even more complicated if the drama was also of a romantic genre. Even though the main character's life journey will be filled with resentment, there will always be sun sign illuminating their grey day. Well, what if the sun sign were the object of his grudge? It is like falling in love with your own enemy. Interesting and more complicated. As always, check the description box for more information. Just give this video a like and do comment below that which C-drama list you want to watch next. And now let's get to it. Number 10. The Song of Glory. Set in the Liuzhong dynasty, with powerful aristocrats clamoring for power, the people of the Liuzhong Empire have succumbed to the ensuing chaos. Desperate to bring peace to his crumbling nation, the young emperor Liu Yikang, son of Emperor Wu of Liuzhong, the founder of the Liuzhong dynasty, is willing to do whatever it takes to save his people. But the road before him will not be easy. With most of the country's powerful families plotting against him, Yikang's list of allies is growing dangerously thin. Knowing the only way to strengthen his position is to ally himself with a mighty family, Yikang agrees to alliance through marriage with the powerful Sen family, a family with deep military roots. The Sen family can provide the strength Yikang needs to enact the reform necessary to oust the aristocrats bent on destroying the nation. With the family's brilliant and beautiful Sen Lige by his side, the two begin the arduous task of reformation. Facing off against one of the nation's most powerful and corrupt clans, Yikang and Lige must use every ounce of their wits and strength to defeat their enemies. But peace doesn't come without a price, and the cost of this battle is tremendous. In the midst of so much heartache and despair, can this noble couple find a way to heal the wounds of a broken nation and at the same time mend the wounds of their own broken hearts? Number 9. You Complete Me. Gao Sang is a highly skilled investment and fund specialist who plans to get revenge against the people who have caused the death of his father. The first step of his plan is to get hired in the investment department of the Most Sky. But due to external factors, he misses the interview appointment. Lin Wo works for a headhunter company that offers high-class clients the perfect candidates to fulfill their business positions. As a subordinate, he caused Gao Sang to be late to his interview. She takes it upon herself to help him get another opportunity. Their first encounter is not a pleasant one, but as they keep meeting up by chance, they begin to build up and trust in each other. This is a story of revenge and love in a business environment. Number 8. Daoluo Continent. One of my favorite anime of all time is Soul Land. And if you guys have not watched that anime, I will recommend you to watch that anime first, then you could watch or even consider to watch this drama. Having lost his mother at a very young age, Tang San grew up relying on his father just as much as his father relied upon him. Meticulous and mature from his age, with extraordinary talent and wit, he was sent to Nording Academy at the age of 16 to begin pursuing his dream of becoming a great soul master. There, under the tutelage of Yu Xiaogang, he befriends an orphan by the name of Xiao, and together they begin the long and difficult journey of cultivation. As time passes, the two friends draw ever closer, eventually swearing to look out for each other as siblings for life. As their power and connection grow, Yu Xiaogang realizes that they need more guidance that he can provide. Sending the pair to the Shriek Academy, Tang Shan and Xiao join 5 other prodigies from various academies in their journey of cultivation. Strong in their power, the 7 students become known throughout the land as the Shriek 7 Devils. When their fame ever growing, the talents of 7 are eventually noticed by a few very prominent nobles who invite them to continue their cultivation at the esteemed Tiandorwal Academy. Not long after accepting the invitation, the 7 devils find themselves caught up in an imperial struggle for power. At the same time, Tang San uncovers a long hidden secret about his mother's death, suddenly facing battles on many fronts. Tang San finds himself forced to fight not only to protect those he loves but to bring honor to his sect, save his country and complete his quest to become the greatest soul master of all time. Number 7. Goodbye My Princess. A love story revolves around the ninth princess of Western Liang as she journeys to the central plains to fulfill a marriage alliance with the crown prince. Having received overwhelming love and admiration as the ninth princess, Xiaofeng is forced to live the life that she has known in order to become the crown princess. Her husband, the black-bellied crown prince, holds the highest position second only to one, the emperor. However, the Stern Palace is the most dangerous place to be. For political reasons, the prince has no choice but to marry the princess from a foreign land. He has his own favored concubine, while she has her own life. Two parallel lines begin to intersect in a place fraught with danger and deadly power play, and buried somewhere deep inside are memories that have yet to resurface. Number 6. The Princess Wei Yang. The Northern Wei Dynasty was obliterated one night, leaving behind the kind-hearted princess Feng Xinar as an orphan. Although she escapes death, she accidentally enters her enemy's territory and she assumes the identity of Li Weiyang, the daughter of the Prime Minister. She suffers many hardships but eventually utilizes her wisdom and sense of justice to become a powerful woman as well as gaining a beautiful romance. Number 5. Bloody Romance. In the turbulent interregnum following the collapse of the Tang Dynasty, a young daughter of a herbalist is tricked and sold to a brothel. After a harrowing escape from death, she finds herself in a city of female assassins. Assuming the name Wan Mei, she begins to learn the ropes of being an assassin from Chang An, a young man who acts as her guide and warden. Over time, Wan Mei and Chang An begin to develop genuine affection for each other, but Jia Liu, the leader of the assassins, takes a dislike to Wan Mei and plots against the couple with her cohorts. Wan Mei's personality and gifts causes Gonzi, the hidden owner of Guihua City, to take an interest in her. Burdened by his hidden identity, Chang An begins to distance himself from Wan Mei. The protagonists find themselves embroiled in escalating conspiracies involving deadly betrayals and struggles for power. Number 4. The Romance of Tiger and Rose. Having finally sold a TV series script, aspiring screenwriter Chen Shaoxian soon falls under the scrutiny of the male lead, who refuses to act out the role. Vowing to make her script successful, she starts rewriting. But while taking a nap, she is transported into her own story, becoming the third princess, Chen Shanxian, a side character killed off in the third episode by the main lead, Prince Han Shuo. Armed with the knowledge of her own script, Shaoxian is determined to stay alive and find her way back home. Number 3. Legend of Fuyao. Adopted as an orphan, Fuyao served as a slave for the Xuanyuan sect in Taiwan Kingdom. After a series of tragedies, she journeyed across the land searching to lift the curse that blighted her life. Along the way, she meets the crown prince of Taishuan, Jiangshun Wuzi, and falls in love with him. Together they tackle many political issues in the Five Kingdoms and unearth secrets regarding her birth. Number 2. The Story of Minglan. Set in the Northern Song Dynasty, this story follows Sheng Minglan, an unfavored concubine born sixth daughter of an official. After losing her mother at a young age, Minglan is then raised by her parental grandmother. Growing up, she learns to hide her true genuine self and use crafty and cunning methods in order to survive the tough conditions where family members are plotting against each other and where no actual family love exists. She then meets Gu Tengye, the second son of a rich Marquis household who is supposed to inherit wealth from both the parents and a noble title. Unlike Minglan, Gu Tengye is straightforward with his actions and never hides his true self, causing him to fall victim to all the planning and plotting against him, where he ends up losing everything. Minglan and Gu Tengye join forces, and through cunning schemes and daring endeavors, they both rise in position and work to obtain justice from those that have wronged them. Number 1. Joy of Life. Fan Xian grew up in a small town by the sea with his grandmother. After an unexpected visit from a poison master, his peaceful life becomes filled with hardships and even danger. He becomes skilled in medicine, the art of poison creation, the martial arts. Needing to discover more about his mysterious mother, he heads for the capital. There he sets out on an adventure of discovery filled with political intrigue, new marvels, and deeply buried family secrets. More importantly, he determines his purpose in life and finds true love along the way. So that was it guys, the video ends here. I hope you have liked this video. If you have watched the video till here, give this video a like and subscribe to Drama YT. And yet you guys have not followed me on the Instagram handle, which is right in front of you. It is called dramayt.k2. Follow me there as well. And I will see you later as always. Your K2. Love, peace and hugs. It's been a pleasure.